Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Kristen Carosa. In the next hour, the trial of a Wolfboro woman accused of neglecting dozens of Great Danes gets underway. Prosecutors say Christina Fay kept 84 Great Danes living in deplorable conditions, but she claims she took great care of the animals. A judge is also deciding whether a veterinarian who traveled from Virginia will be allowed to once again examine the Great Danes before she testifies. Right now, a Superior Court judge is deciding if a defamation case brought by the mayor of the state's largest city can move forward. Manchester Mayor Ted Gatsas is accusing two men of knowingly making false allegations against him after an incident at a public school. WMUR's Ray Brewer has the court arguments.
This case began after news reports surfaced of a rape at West High School back in 2015.
With Manchester's Mayor Ted Gatsas looking on, lawyers for the men he's suing argued Monday that Gatsas' defamation lawsuit should be tossed out, saying it's lacking in facts.
There is nothing in the complaint that explains why the plaintiff believes the defendants knew or entertained serious doubt that any of those statements were false.
Back in June, John Hopwood, who was in court, and former Alderman William Cashin, who was absent, sent a letter to the city council. The letter alleging that Gatsas engineered a cover-up of the sexual assault at West High. The mayor claims the two wrote the letter and made it public with actual malice, knowing the statements were false.
The complaint is silent on why any of those statements are false.
This complaint lays out the statements that we claim are defamatory.
The suit claims that there were 17 such statements and that they were untrue. Gatsas' lawyer, Richard Lehman, told the court it's unreasonable for the defense to say they need more specifics at this point.
How and why they are false are the things that get fleshed out through discovery and depositions, and ultimately whether they are false is tried to a jury.
The judge took the case under advisement, giving each side 10 days to file additional pleadings. In Manchester, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
Authorities are giving the all clear this noon after the bomb squad was called to 7-Eleven in Hudson to investigate a suspicious device. Police say a noise was coming from inside the mailbox in front of the store on Central Street late last night. The store was closed for 2 hours as the techs x-rayed the mailbox. It turned out to be a cell phone packaged for return. The Attorney General's office is warning about an email scam. The fake email looks like it's from the New Hampshire Department of Motor Vehicles and says the recipient was cited with a traffic violation and demands payment within 72 hours. The email contains links for easy pay or a way to contest the fine. If you get this, you're warned not to click on any of the links and not to provide any personal information. Starting tonight at 5, heading into the fire zone, how crews from New Hampshire are hoping to offer relief in California. And walking again, the Vegas survivor shocking surgeons tonight, her remarkable story of recovery. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.